You know, what I do for the most part now is the other side of culinary, the hospitality. So I've done a lot of front of house operations, you know, I've done back server, server, barista, bartender, whatever. Now what I do is I do HR for all of the businesses that I work for. Like, I guess my thing is, when I first started working there, I didn't really know what it was that I wanted to do. And working in restaurants gave me that opportunity to actually make it. You know, so like, right now, y'all are going through high school, you may not know anything you really want to do, and that's okay. You know, you take the time to figure it out, and then you can do whatever it is that y'all want.
Any questions? No? No questions? Not one question for me? All right, it's okay. You have some questions in the demo. All right, I'm going to have Kelly step up now.
So I'm the polar opposite of what I did. I kind of foresee the background of kitchen aspect. I've been working in restaurants for over 15 years. It's wild, I know. But I've always had a partake to food, whether or not it was career-related. I'm a very family-oriented person, so our table was built around food. We'd make an entire event over it for a day just to go hang out with our grandparents, and all of our family would be involved and partake into something to make for that night, to just be around family, and it's kind of cool, you know? Food's the underlying language of every walk of life. You can speak to anybody without speaking that language, but you can feed them your food. Which is kind of what drove me into my career, you know? I can speak fluently with food, I can teach anybody, I can learn from anybody, as well as knowing their language. It's kind of cool being in this industry for so long. You see so much other things that involve food that doesn't necessarily come around the thing that you put into your body for 6 months. It's kind of cool. Anybody want to work in a restaurant? Anybody want to own a restaurant? Yeah? What kind of food do you want?
I don't really know.
You don't really know?
What type of food do you like?
Yeah, what do you like?
I mean, I'm Greek, so.
That's amazing. That's a new cuisine that I've learned since moving away from home. I was born and raised in Hawaii, and eating has brought me all the way to New York City over a course of time. And so, learning Greek food is absolutely stunning. One of my favorite restaurants is down the block from me. It's a Greek and Cypriot cuisine, and I go all the time. They know me by name. Yeah? Oh, yeah.
Hold up, this is good.
Yeah.
All right, we ready for this demo? All right, guys. Let's all get into the kitchen.
Yeah,
How is it? Do you taste the ginger? No. Is it too sweet?
Bro, you get it.
Like, it's not spicy.
It's not spicy, but you can definitely taste it. So at this point, just transfer this and then
so
just
they're making a ginger
drink. So we're definitely going to have time. Front of house one is just there to be that last line of defense.
like describe a situation where, like, you had to like multitask?
Yeah, I mean, when you work as a server, let's say, especially earlier.
How would you handle like angry with like a very unsatisfied
customer? Customer's always right. No, I mean. So, in those situations, it's just a matter of, like I said, checking in with them. And if you're unable to provide, you know, the guest with whatever requirements or expectation that they're trying to meet, then at that point, it is good to reach out to a manager and have them step in just to help you out. And sometimes all it takes is a fresh face or a new face, you know, to be able to communicate those situations.
All right, and I'm going to give this time to Chef Kelly. Can we all say thank you to Isaiah, please?
Thank you.
What's up, gang? I've been cooking in restaurants for a really long time now. I got here a little while ago. Yeah, it's been almost 15 years. At the age of 7, all I knew is that I wanted to cook. So I built my entire life revolved around food. Hawaii is just one of these things where we grew up around the dinner table, so we kind of just make huge events of it. And then I was just like, oh, I'm just making my career. Why not? Oh, I like cooking. Just take a go. And so I went. So I moved from a Little Rock in the Pacific Ocean, and now I'm here on the Liberty Island in the middle of New York City. It's absolutely incredible, nonetheless, to build so much experiences through food and through restaurants. I do like to say a lot that food is the underlying language of all people. Doesn't matter what language you speak, I can still feed you food. And vice versa. I love being fed more than I like cooking, because food tastes better to me when I don't have to make it. Funny enough. However, when it comes down to restaurants, Isaiah is not wrong. Like, it is a very hard situation. And it just all depends on how much you really want it. Restaurant speaking specifically, it's an entire piece in itself. And he's not wrong. There are two sides to the house, but we're one house exclusively, especially at that pass, as is one of the best experts that I've worked with in front of. And it does become a lot for back of the house to like have to do all of these things, turn around, and then put it out into the existence. And that's where we put all of that stress in a sort of sense to trust somebody else to be able to get our food from them. So yeah, expediting is definitely one of the hardest jobs inside of a restaurant, but it's the most exploring. However, I mean, I don't know. Where do you want to go?
It's true. It's up to you. It's up to you to decide. Are you more comfortable in front of house, or are you more comfortable in back of house? What is your place within hospitality, which is so versatile? There's so many aspects. I'm gonna pick on Melody.
Sorry.
Who raised their hand? Song, then Melody.
Have you ever felt so overwhelmed, like on the edge of quitting?
I did.
We all did.
100%.
I did too.
So not for nothing, you build this short sort of just like general aura of pride. Not necessarily an ego anyway, but you have like this overwhelming sense of pride. Like, you're so happy to put what it is that you're putting on that plate and give it out to me. And then it just becomes an afterthought, and you go through motions. Just constantly going through the trenches with those who are standing beside you every day. And cooks don't work short hours, so a day off to me is working 8 hours. Granted, we'll work anywhere between like 12 to 16. However, we are definitely working towards a better life of work-life balances, and it's absolutely stunning how we have people perform better by allowing them to have that work-life balance. I'm not one of those who have a work-life balance on the account of my life is my work, and I take huge pride into it. But that's just because I love what I do. You know, like every excuse that I would find to hide an emotion, I would go to work and cook my emotions, essentially. So at one point, it did become a lot overwhelming. I had to step away what made me comfortable to allow myself to figure it out, to do what I can do better. So I stepped out of kitchens last year. I haven't been in a kitchen for a solid year now. Now I'm back into it, doing pastry and doing something that I actually love. I mean, I love it nonetheless, but like being able to put my thoughts on a piece of paper and then to other people, being able to share knowledge, it's different. I spread my stress less.
All right, let's go get this demo done.
Yeah, what are we doing next?
We're making cookies, gang.
Cookies! Yeah. Oh, shit.
Thing. When you bring in butter and sugar, you want your sugar granules to get to the point where it needs to be to crystallize without burning. So creaming your butter and sugar will allow your fat to dissolve your sugar. It'll become nice and fluffy. It'll give your non-leavened cookies some texture.
What?
Get it going. Make sure it's soft enough. Two, so you can control how much you mix your dough.
Money.